What's going on YouTube? Rob A again, and today we're going to be taking a look at Fansproject, Causality, Crossfire, CA-13 Diesel, and Military Multiplexer Kit. So Fansproject Diesel. Let's just call it that for short. A lot of history behind this guy here. He's the final part in the Causality Intimidator set. And you couldn't tell it by looking at the box, because they don't actually show any images of the completed Intimidator. You can see that it shows a pretty cool drawing of the figure here on the front, and then, you know, an image on the side. And on the back, it shows you, like, all of his different parts and configurations, you know, all of his weaponed up modes and everything else, and then even the huge sword on his back. But nowhere does it show Intimidator in his completed form, so that's kind of odd, but alright. I've been waiting for this guy for a long time, and I have to say, I was not as excited to have this guy show up as I should have been, I think, just because, oh man, it's been such a long time. There was an initial delay in the figure's release until after the new year. And then there were problems with my old address. It wasn't, you know, didn't the BBTS, you know, had a problem, you know, sending this out to me in the first place. And then when we got that cleared up, and then it got sent by train, and then the train got delayed due to weather, and then, you know, it hit over the weekend. So there was over the weekend, and then so he's in my hands now. So I'm excited to have him. I am. I just hope he's cool, because all the other guys, the more I mess with them, the more difficult I find that they are to actually just deal with. They're so fiddly, and I've mentioned that. But anyway, I'm gonna stop harping on that. I'm just gonna get this guy out of the package, and we will check him out in hand. All right, guys. So in the package, you get Diesel here. You get the collector card, of course, with the weird, you know, thing on the back. I'm not going to read this off, and it's odd though, because this part seems to be blacked out. Although it looks like that's intentional, because there were no words written, you know, printed under there. I think this is intentionally blacked out. But here, I'll leave this up, and you can pause the video if you want to read it, because that's a whole lot of stuff. So anyway, there is that. You also get this handy dandy, I'm gonna pull the camera back here, handy dandy instruction booklet, and it shows you just all of his different transformations and robot to vehicle. Oh, I didn't even realize that. Yeah, I got this guy last night just before I went to bed. It came that late. It came really, really late. And I just transformed the robot here once, just to see what it was all about and how difficult it was, because I heard it was very difficult. I managed to get the robot into robot mode without any trouble at all, really. I didn't have to look at the instructions, but getting back into vehicle mode was a bit more difficult for me. But anyway, that said, these are the instructions. You can see Intimidator on the back here. This shows you the various transformations for all the limbs, I guess, if you can really call them that. And then here he is. So the cab rolls nicely. These back wheels are part of this shield piece, and they sometimes don't want to touch the ground, because I guess the wheels are independently fixed on there. So you got that. His wheels can come out to the side like that. I imagine that's for the Intimidator transformation. But he's a cool looking truck. I mean, he's nice, he's long, he's solid, very solid in this mode. And I'll show you guys. Here he is with the rest of his crew. And he looks decent with these guys. He's a little small, to be honest. The cab is a little bit small. But I imagine, you know, he's so large in robot mode compared to these guys that I imagine they couldn't make it, you know, really match scale-wise in vehicle mode. So, but there he is with those guys. And you got a couple of things going on here. So you can see he's got the long trailer going on. But what you can do is you come back here and you can kind of lift this panel and just pull this off the back end of the trailer. And then he's got this little squatty cab thing. And you come back here, you can pull this piece off. And this all comes out. I like that all the pieces are integrated into the trailer. I'm not a huge fan of how many little pieces are involved here. I mean, it's just so much tiny little pieces and bits that I'm concerned about losing. I know they can all store on the truck, but this one doesn't plug on all that super securely. But you know, just things to kind of look out for and be aware of. So there you go, and you can put that on, and now he's a little squatty fish truck. He can deliver bread to stores early in the morning. You can put this on the back for whatever reason. And there you go, you've got that. This part of the cab basically stores all of the Intimidator bits. It's got the hands in there, it's got the sword. You can see the tip of the sword there as well, but we'll get into that later. What we're gonna do right now, let's put that off to the side. We're gonna pull this guy out, take this off, it came off by itself. And we will transform him to robot mode. So give me just a moment, and we will get that started. All right, so to transform Diesel into robot mode, the first thing you want to do is, if you have these panels in here, you just want to pop them out, and you just kind of put your thumb between them, and then push them out, because they're just held in by friction like that. So just put those off to the side for the moment. Then you want to come up here and just take the top of the trailer and just kind of pop it off one side at a time, because it is keyed up here, you can see. So like that, and then the other side, and then you can just bring the whole side panel down like so. All right, and just fold it up, and then fold it up like that. Just do that on both sides. Then you want to take the wheels back here into this whole panel and just rotate it back just like so. And you can do this now if you want, or you can wait, but you can also take the wheels and just kind of turn those in around. They do have little studs back here that they kind of clip onto. You can kind of see right there. And they may not always want to go onto those the first time around, just because everything's real tight, but you can just clip them on. And then those are pretty much done for right now. Next thing you want to do is just take this whole front section here and just pull it back. That's going to kind of be the waist piece of your robot. All right. Just kind of get that up and out of the way. Then you want to take this chest panel and just pull it down. These two chunks are like pegged in there. There you go. So just get those out of the way. And these are going to be the shoulders of the robot. So you just want to rotate them up. All the way up like that. All the way up like that. And just leave that for right now. Okay? Next, you want to take the hips here. You just kind of get them out of the way like so. And then accordion the waist up and just peg it in right here. You can see these two pegs and the two holes in the waist piece. And just plug those right in. All right. Now for Diesel, you actually want the purple part of the pelvis facing forward. So you want to just rotate that around until it's purple in the front. And these waist covers are for Intimidator, so they stay in the back here. Then you just want to come around here, push in on the bumper, and split the whole front half of the cab into two, just like so. Give yourself some room. Now these very thin bits right here, these thin stalks, are actually going to be the knees, and you have to rotate on that piece, and it can be a little scary at first. So you just do that, okay? And then the you can see on the inside of the cab front, there's a little slot here and a tab right here. Just gonna push that right in like so. Okay? And then to make the foot, you're gonna pull this whole piece right here is just gonna come forward like so. Alright. Then this piece is going to come back and combine to form the foot. And you just kind of push it in, and there you have the foot area. Just flip that piece back. And there is one leg done. Isn't that exciting? Very, very exciting. You just do the same thing on the other side. Just the scary snapping and moving of the very thin pieces. Just coordinating it all in. Clip it together. Move this bit out. Mm-hmm. There you go. Actually, you should pull the foot out. I'm sorry, I've been doing it a little backwards. You should pull the foot out before you accordion this piece in, just because it has to lock into place there. But I've been doing it a little bit out of order, and I apologize deeply for that. And then just get the foot kind of adjusted, and then close it up. And this one doesn't want to snap into place for some reason. There we go. That's got it. His hip joints are very strong, so hopefully he'll be nice and stable in Intimidator mode. Now, for the big head reveal. Put that up. I'm gonna flip this up, just like that, and then snap the chest plate into place and turn his head around. And there's his head, and I'll show you guys a close-up of that real quick. I actually really, really like his head sculpt. I know a lot of people say it's not traditional Motor Master, mostly because this thing is smaller, but I really like it. I think it's got, I mean, it's a very straightforward face, but I think it's got a lot of I love the sculpting, I guess, and the colors, I think, are really what does it for me. But all right, so you want to come around here, shoulders, we'll make the arms here. You've got the back plate right here, and you just want to flip that up. Just kind of pull the whole arm assembly down, and then just push it out and rotate the fist. And then, unfortunately, up here at the shoulders, these do not lock in place at all. So you're gonna get a lot of this kind of thing going on when you're trying to just rotate the arm, so just be aware of that. And then the other side is the same. Just flip that out, pull the arm down, pull the fist out, and then there you go. And these you can kind of adjust a little bit. They do move up and down back here, like so. So you can rotate them up a little bit more. That's mostly for Intimidator mode, where they rotate up all the way, but you can get them down far enough that they can rotate up at least a little bit. And he is stable enough that he can hold them up like that. And I think they look, I mean, they stick out a bit far, but I think it looks better overall than some of the other positions that you can have. Just be very, very careful, because on mine there are already stress marks on the insides just from trying to rotate these around. They They like to stress that piece. So just be very careful of that. And then you should be okay. And I don't know why this isn't... Oh, there we go. It helps to have the wheels not quite rotated fully in. And then you can get that kind of upward facing thing. So, all right. And there is Intimidator in robot mode. So, very cool. I really like his robot mode. He's very large. Almost badly large, if I can say. Just because we'll put him back here, and then we'll do a comparison with his compatriots here. These are his teammates. And I don't know. There's something I don't particularly like. Such a disparity between, his Limbots and himself. But I guess there's not really too much you can do about that. I mean, he is a truck compared to these little, cars, race cars and things like that. So it's going to be a tough thing no matter what you do. But we'll put these guys off to the side again, and we'll show him all armored up. We'll do a quick size comparison here. I have with Fortis from Mastermind Creations. You can see they're about the same size. Diesel is a little bit taller at the head. But they are very, very close in size together. So I'll put him off to the side again. And let's get this whole trailer chunk out, because now is where this stuff comes into play. So I will pause the video here and I'll be right back. Alright guys, time to open Diesel's magical box of wonders and armor this dude up. And so what you want to do first is, if you put the back of the truck back on, you want to just take this bit off. And that's not supposed to come off yet. That's okay though. It just pops right back on, in theory. There you go, pops right back on. These, again, just put your thumb, boop, just like that. And we're going to go ahead and just take these two back bits, and you're just going to fold them right in half. And again, all this stuff turns these into a large, gigantic rifle that I'm going to save for Intimidator rather than this guy. But we'll give him these two shotguns. So I'll put this off to the side. We'll take this, and we're just going to pull the handle of the sword off, and I'm going to leave that for Intimidator as well. And then this can just pop off eventually. There we go. And this can be used as a shield or something. It's got a little handle in here. That's super fun to get out. And, yeah, he can, I guess, hold it as a shield or something. And, yeah, I don't really, this thing's not really for me. But you can use that. You can plug it onto his shoulder or whatever afterwards. And I'll show that in just a minute. But this is the meat of it. This is his trailer. And as you can see, it's identical on both sides. It doesn't really matter so much which way you have this facing. But yeah, actually, well, this way has to be the back. You can have it like either up or down. It doesn't matter that way. So what you want to do is just pull this apart like so, just in half. And these are pieces of the sword, which I'm going to put right aside. Just move this back a little bit so you can see what's going on here. Sword bit, and these are going to be the hands of our dear friend Intimidator. We're just going to pull these right out. So you can see we've got some hands going on here. Okay. And on this side, more hands. Come on, buddy. Come on, buddy. He doesn't want to let go. There we go. All right. Just put those off. And then we're left with these two bits here. And what you want to do for these is take these panels with the pointed bit and just kind of push them up like so. Okay. And you just want to pull these two apart. And as you can see, there's some missiles molded and painted in here. You want to just flip the missile pods out to the side, like so. And then basically you're just going to accordion this in on itself, just like that. And it's going to snap in very securely so that it'll be very scary trying to get it out. And then just like that. And there you have one shoulder cannon missile battery thing. And then just do the same thing on the other side. Just pull it up. And this is the side that gives me all the trouble. It doesn't want to behave here, so. Just got to be careful with it, because it's all thin panels, and I don't want to break anything. There we go. Let's flip these bits out. Flip these bits out. Pull this apart. And then just bring it back in. And it just clicks into place like so. And then with these, you come around and you go to his back area. And you see there's this little hole right here. And you just plug this in to that hole. If you can get it to plug in. Word has it, it's supposed to plug in there. According to the... Oh. You know what? I'm an idiot. It's going in this slot here. Not the hole. Pay no attention to me. The instructions are not the most clear. So, please. Please bear that in mind. And then this goes in on the other side here. In the slot, not in the hole. Oy, oy, oy. These are adjustable, so you may want to move them back a little bit to get that in properly, and it does not. There we go. There we go. And so you can see Intimidator is already, or Diesel is already starting to get more beefy as we go. These bits, as you can see, have kind of cannons and then these missile pods going on here. Not much changes about this at all. You just kind of pop out the connector ports on his shoulders. And then you can just plug this in. I believe it's keyed. So you plug it in that way. I don't know if I'm just not pushing it enough. There we go. And then, okay. Come on, buddy. There you go. So, once you get that, he's got these large guns on his shoulders as well. Go. Just push it in. Pay no attention to this part of the video. It's you'll only be frustrated. Yeah. Okay. Let me pause this and fight with this thing, and then I'll come back when it looks like I've done it.
All right.
So, there he is. I got it on. And basically, all I had to do to get it on was just kind of stick my finger in there and just press down on the little release tab that's on the thing. And now you can take this shoulder or this shield piece, and you can see it's got this tab sticking out of it. And you can just kind of stick it right in here. And there you go. He's got a extra thing on his shoulder. Now he's having a little bit of a harder time standing upright. I mean, he's got very solid, nice, stiff joints, but there's a lot of weight on top of this guy right now. And then finally, we can add these bits here. And it says in the instructions that you can kind of take the hands and just fold them up, kind of, and plug them into the back here, just to, I guess, hide them and have them all, you know, have everything attached at once. So you can do that if you want. I'm just going to leave the other one off to the side right now, because it's just not, it's not important. But you can stick these little short shotties, not really short, but these guns in his hands. And there he is. He desperately wants to fall forward. You can just feel it. So you lean him back, and then he wants to fall back. This guy is covered in stuff. So you can see he's got a lot going on here. A lot of stuff going on here. But he is mostly standing. I mean, he just requires a little bit of fiddling. I can move that down there. Just a little bit of fiddling around to kind of get him stable. But he can do it, and that thing fell off, so whatever. But he can indeed stand up, so... yeah, very, very well armored. Yeah, so I'll go over articulation, I guess. His head is on a ball joint, so you get nice range of motion with that. His arms can swivel into his chest as well. They have a... Here, I'll pop this stuff off, so. This going on, he's got the bicep swivel. He's got a double jointed elbow here, wrist swivel. He does have a hip swivel, like so. Very, very stiff hip swivel. Now go back, hip swivel, thank you. he's got ratcheting hips. He's got an upper thigh swivel. He's got very fiddly knee, as you can see there. But he does have a knee. It is a bit limited, but it can get pretty far back as long as you, about that far, you know, so not bad, not bad. And of course his feet are on stocks and hinges and swivels and ball joints. So he's got lots of range in his feet, which is good. But, this shoulder thing is rather obnoxious, I've got to say. It would be nice if maybe his, this chest piece had just a little bit more here that could just kind of press against that and keep it in place. But, you know, you can't have everything. He's a cool figure overall. So definitely has that going for him. But I think it's time, guys. I think it's time for me to combine my very first third-party combiner, and let's check out Intimidator. So I will be right back. Okay, guys, so to change Diesel into M3 or Intimidator or whatever he's being called these days, you want to just pop these guys up just to get that right out of the way. And then you're just going to take his whole torso and just pull it right back and just kind of sit it like that. You want to open up his chest panel, turn his head around, and then from the back, you want to just push this little slidey bit here and then twist up Intimidator's head. I'm just going to pop out like that and then just adjust his little head crest, and then you can push Diesel's head down just like so. Next thing you want to do is twist these arm bits back like this, just like as if you were transforming it back into vehicle mode, and then you want to take these bits, his arms, because these are going to end up like so. So kind of twist them around so that the silver bit is facing up and the pegs are facing out, and then these are out like so. So just kind of turn everything around so it's like that. And then you want to transform his arms just as though he were going back into vehicle mode again. So just like that. And then this bit goes down like so. Push it in, push it down, and then this bit goes down like so. Where are we getting fouled up? There we go. Okay. Like that. Alright. And then these bits are actually going to come up, and you'll see there's a little indent there. It's going to clip over this, and then this peg is going to clip into this slot in the chest plate. So basically, Diesel's chest is going to be Intimidator's back. So you just want to kind of get that all lined up and then can take some, take a little bit of doing just to line everything up just so. There you go. And get the other side. There we are. Alright, so now he should be pretty well set. Just like that. Alright. Cool stuff. Cool stuff. Okay, so then what you're going to want to do is take this whole section and turn it around like so. Okay. And then flip this up and clip it. Oh. Clip it kind of. Oh, sorry. Did that wrong. You gotta get these out of the way. These are kind of in the way. So these make it a little hard to see what I'm doing. I'm sorry, guys. So basically, you're just going to flip the whole guy up here. And then that should... Yeah. All right, fine. These are on ball joints. Just take them right off. You want to just clip this guy into place. All right. There you go. Oh boy. Okay, so now we're going to take the upper part of the waist and twist that around so that these are facing forward and that this piece without the purple is the front. Okay? Alrighty. Now, what I'm going to do is put these back on. So now they should be okay. Like that, because now they can slide out and they can actually come up here and they'll lock into place, which is nice. So now they have free range of motion here, and then there's this little tab that's gonna plug right into this little bit here. Well, as soon as I get that all figured out, there you go. And that should be pretty solid, just like that. All right, so now that we have the upper part of the body pretty well set to go, we're gonna take care of the legs. And this seems really tricky at first, but it's really pretty simple. We're just gonna open up the flaps here. Then we're gonna take the feet, and we're just gonna pull this whole thing that's facing down, we're just gonna pull this whole black piece forward like so, and then we're basically just gonna swing the feet around. Just be careful because the ball joint is on this little stalk, and it's very stiff, so the ball joint will have a tendency to pop out every once in a while. So just make sure this gray piece is down, this is out, and then just twist it around and just plug it into the side just like that. do the same thing on the other side here. Just bring it all the way forward. All the way forward. Then the gray piece comes down. This comes up. And then the foot just comes around. Just being careful of the ball joint. And then just plugs into this slot on the side. Get in there, buddy. Get in there, buddy. There we go. Okay, now let's open this up again. We're just going to bring this whole assembly up alongside the upper leg now. Okay, just bring it all up. And just smash it against the upper leg here. Okay, now the front of the cab is going to plug in just like it did for the leg on this square post here. Okay, and the combiner ports are going to come down and they're going to tab right into these bits here. So you've got a tab here and kind of a little slot right there, and then a tab here and a slot there. So let's get that all lined up, and hopefully that'll plug in securely, just like so. And then there you go, you've got the main body. And then you can see he's got the hip flaps that kind of get out of the way for leg movement. He's got limited backwards movement here, but he's got good side-to-side motion, and I'm sure you can get some decent poses out of him here. So, cool, right? Right. And then we'll just clip this back in because it wants to, does not want to lock into place at all. So, get that out, pop it in. Why must you be difficult? There we go. And then clip that back in. I wish it locked in better than that, but, you know, what are you going to do? Can't have everything, I guess. But, all right. So, there we have the main body of Intimidator. Now here's where things get kind of crazy, because now we have all this stuff left. And this is the part that kind of irks me a little bit, because we have so much just stuff left over that it's just like, nah. All right, so first we're going to take this bit here. This is the chest piece, whatever you call it. We're going to swing these wheels out to the side. We're going to push this bit in. And then this is going to go onto the chest of our friend here. Just like so. Hopefully it'll go on nice and securely. Maybe. I guess it's on. I hope it's securely on, but only time will tell. There, it does seem to be quite a gap just up in the top there. That's kind of obnoxious, but you know, whatever. It doesn't feel like it's gone in very far, and it doesn't feel like it's clicked in or locked in at all. So I'm a little concerned that's not going to stay, but we'll just take it as it is for now. We'll grab our little, these guys right here. Okay. And we're going to just pull this out like so. And then I guess these just kind of stay as they are. Right? Yep. These just stay like that. And these, I think, are going to be the shins. Okay. So just like so. Alright. Now these bits, we are going to get this part and just pull it out here. This part, just pull it out. And now these bits are going to become the feet. So we're going to take these, just kind of lock it into place here. And then these bits are going to come around and forward. Just like so. And this, I assume, is not really going to lock into place, but just kind of peg into place. And then that will be a foot, which is interesting. All right, we get one of our shins, and we just plug it into the foot here. Okay, so there you have the lower leg. Just put that right back. I'm going to do the same thing over here. Lift this up, pull these around. Snap them together. These go underneath, snap together, and then take our shin and just plug it just like so. Okay, so there you have the lower legs, and now we can attach them. And of course, we, again, it's keyed, so we want to take. And it doesn't want to stick together, but okay. It's keyed, so you start with the little bump facing up, and the little bump there. You click it, and then just turn it right around. Same thing on the other side. Just hold this down because it'll pop out, and then you'll have instability. All right. And there we have the start of our combiner guy. And I have to say, his head already looks a little small for the size of this dude, but we'll see. We'll see how she goes. And now, it wants us to attach the cars, so I'm going to grab this. You're basically supposed to just transform it into car mode and then just flip this out, but I just figured if I have these out to the side as well, it might look a little better. And so you're going to use these three holes right here and just get this guy lined up and then just plug him on. There we go, like so. And there you have one leg done. Okay. And the other guy, and I think this one looks a little bit better. I'm just going to get this guy lined up. Then just plugged on. All right. And there we have some legs going on here. Yeah, his legs look really, really big compared to the rest of him, but that's all right. So, next up come the arms. And what we want to do for those is we're going to take these little guys here, okay? And we're going to grab our right arm, okay? And so we want to just go ahead and slide these bits over his waist. You see he's got these little kind of tabs on his waist here. Just want to slide these over those tabs, like so. Give him a nice hug. And then this peg is going to go into that hole right there. And there you go. There's one arm kind of ready to go. But first, we're going to go ahead and attach the hand in here. So we're going to take his hand, And we're just going to split his legs apart just a little bit. And the hand is going to just go right in between the wheels. Like so. There you go. So that's the hand. I'm going to push these up. And his gun can just attach to the side of his body, I guess. Just like so. And there you have one arm ready. Just going to put that right onto the side. Now for the other arm, you're going to do the same thing here. You got the little tab guy. You're going to just give him a hug around the waist. And then just push it in. Get it on there, just like so. You can see his gun attaches right here. Now, it does say that you can take this bit and just plug it in here to kind of fill in the, I guess, the gap in his arm. Because this guy doesn't have any stuff in there. However, I want to use this for the gun, so I'm not going to do that, but this guy does, in fact, have these bits that can fold in and over. So it does fill in that gap. It makes it a little thin from the side, but I think it looks just fine from pretty much all the other angles. And then you just want to pop the other hand in here. If it wants to behave for me. I don't know why it's not. Maybe I have to twist this around. Maybe it's got to be this way. Alright, so we just plug this all back together. Okay. And there is his other arm, I guess. So, yeah, I think it helps if you get the robot feet kind of out of the way. So we'll just push those back up and kind of get them out there. Okay, so now we have all the arms and stuff. And then we can go ahead and just plug those on. There we go. Now this side, and again, I'll push the pin in here. It still doesn't want to behave. Mm-hmm. There we go. All right. Okay, guys, and there we have Intimidator in all of his glory. And his body looks a lot less small now that he's got the arms attached. His head still looks a little bit on the small side. That kind of gives you a decent idea. So, pretty cool. He's obviously quite large. We'll do another comparison here. Here he is with the Mastermind Fortis. So, yeah, he's got some good height on him. And now let's put his sword and gun together. And so we'll take the sword handle here. We've got the two halves. We're just going to kind of plug them together. Like so. Okay. The tip of the sword is going to go and kind of go around both halves to keep them together, and then this bit's going to plug just right into the handle here. So there is the sword. It's very nice size, as you can see, and that can just go in his hand. He's actually got a tab here, so you can kind of get this in, just tab it on, and then just wrap his fingers around the handle. And there he can hold his sword. All right. Now for the gun, you want to take the two shotguns here and this bit that came off the back of the truck. And you just want to kind of separate all the pieces. It's got a bunch of just pieces on here. It's that. There's that. And then this comes off as well. So what you want to do here is clip one half onto one shotgun here. And then you want to take this bit and just plug it into the front here, like so. And then just take the other shotgun and just kind of get that, just wrestle it onto the clip. So much work involved. So much work. Yeah, does not want to behave at all. There we go. There we are. Okay, that's got it. So you end up with that. Now you want to take this piece, and this is going to go down over the handle, just like so. And this is going to come around and swing down and do that. And then you grab this piece, and it's keyed, and you just slide it on the front there, like so. And then you have a nice big rifle to put in Intimidator's other hand. And again, it's got the little slot, so you can just, yep. Apparently it's easier just to take the hand out, put the gun in. Sheesh. No, maybe not. Is this not going to work at all? I'm pretty sure that's what it was for. Okay. There we go. gosh. All right. Now we can just plug this back on, hopefully. And slot these back together. And there you go. Now he has his big ol' rifle as well. So, very nice, very nice. There we are. So yeah, very cool. I really think he looks pretty darn awesome in his combined configuration. You can store the sword on his back here. You can see there's a little tab up here on the wheel wells that you can just plug the sword in. It's got this little slot right here. You can plug it in, so we can carry that. Yeah, pretty still very poseable. He's got his waist swivel. Very stiff waist swivel, just like that. Still got all the motion in his legs, just like so. The knees can bend, hopefully at the place where they're supposed to. Maybe not so much. I'm confused. Oh yeah, okay. So his knees can bend. They're just very stiff. There you go. And these parts tend to get in the way of some of his knee bend, but his feet are very poseable. They're on ball joints. They're on big ball joints, and then they're also on the pivot swivel sort of thing. So you get that. These black bits on the bottom here, and here are actually rubber. So he's got very nice traction stability. Unfortunately, my uh, this guy Breakdown over here, he's got a very floppy bit, so that doesn't like to cover his head very well, but head is on a ball joint and on this like little rocking plate, so you can get a lot of good motion out of that. So up at the arms, he has shoulder rotation. He's got a little bit of up and down due to just the way it goes. This part tends to get in the way of a lot of up, but he's got some. He's got a bicep swivel thanks to the natural waist on the car figure. And he's also got a double-jointed elbow, which is pretty cool. So you get a lot of poses that way. And, of course, he's got the wrist swivel. Very, very cool. Very nicely done. I am curious to see what another third-party group will do with the same character, perhaps. Because this guy's cool, and he's my first third-party combiner. And I really do like him a lot. But I can't help but feel a bit of the, I just stuck some cars onto some robot legs, and that's what I got. I understand that that's kind of what Menasor is, but I would have liked to see a little more integration than just literally just pegging them straight onto the legs that were pretty much already fully formed. I mean, he could stand on his own just fine without the robot legs, or without the cars attached to the legs. So I would like to see maybe a little more integration there. But other than that, he's really cool. The only problem is just such a fiddly transformation for all the components, all the separate limb cars and things like that. So it ends up being that, yeah, I love having him in this mode, and I'm probably going to keep him in this mode because it's just such a pain in the butt. Like, he's not a toy you can play with, really. He's a figure you can put together once, pose him. You can pose him around every once in a while, you know, but you're not going to be taking the parts off and transforming the cars back and forth. You're just not going to want to do that because it's not any fun. I admire the engineering. I really do. The engineering is amazing on this guy. It's really a feat, but when I buy a Transformer, what I'm looking for, even in not necessarily display pieces, because this guy is a really great display piece, but what I really want is something that's going to be fun for me to transform, to handle, to be able to hand it to like a friend and say, hey, check it out, check this thing out, and not be like, yeah, here's what I got, but you can't touch it because you'll break it, it'll explode in your hands. But other than that, I mean, I do like it. I don't want to give the impression that I don't. It's quite an investment for the size of the figures that you get, and I understand the main combiner is nicely sized, but I don't know. I'm on the fence a little bit about this one, guys, I have to admit. So I do like it. I give it a thumbs up. But it definitely has its flaws. It definitely take all of this with just, you know, a grain of salt, as it were. But I think that's going to do it for this review, guys. It's certainly been long enough. Thank you for watching me struggle through this combiner, try to get it correct. This is the first time I've transformed him, so I appreciate your patience and all of that. But give me a like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. Thank you so very much for watching, as always, guys. And I can't wait to do more third-party combiners. I'm really excited, super excited for Rex and Warbitron I have coming up as well. So stay tuned for that, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.